हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू आवर सिक्स वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ कंप्यूटर एंड नेटवर्क सिक्योरिटी। माई सेल्फ निकुल जायसवाल, लेक्चरर इन कंप्यूटर इंजीनियरिंग, श्री के जे पॉलिटेक्निक, भरूच। नाउ दिस विल बी अवर लास्ट लेक्चर इन यूनिट नंबर 1। सो इन दिस यूनिट वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस थ्रेट टू सिक्योरिटी, स्टेप्स इन अटैक, सिक्योरिटी बेसिक्स एंड टाइप्स ऑफ अटैक। नाउ इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल सी वेरियस अटैक्स इन टाइप्स ऑफ अटैक्स। So in the previous lecture, we have discussed man-in-the-middle attack, TCP/IP hacking and phishing. So in the man-in-the-middle attack, what the attacker will do, it will put himself in between the communication between two authentic users, and all the communication between two users will pass through the attacker only. So that is the man-in-the-middle attack. Next was the TCP/IP hacking. So in the TCP/IP hacking, we all know that for the TCP communication, we use three-way handshake to establish the connection. Now what the attacker will do, it will hijack the TCP connection that has been established by two users, and it will use that session or the connection to bypass the authentication mechanism in the TCP. And the last was phishing attack. So in the phishing attack, normally we create a fake web page, and it is also called as a one type of social engineering attack. So we will create the face, attacker will create the fake web page, and it will send that web page link to user. User will click on that link and enter its username and password to that link. And when it press on the submit button, a username and password will captured by the attacker. Now in this particular lecture, we will see SQL infection and various malicious code that are present to attack a computer system. Now let's discuss next SQL injection. Now SQL injection is a code in the injection technique. So we all know that we store the data in the database and we access the data by the SQL. So we use various select queries, then union queries to access the data from the database. So there will be one application program, and that will be called as a front end, and there will be a database that will be called as a back end. So we access the data from the database through the application program. An application program uses the SQL to access the data from the database. So in the SQL injection, what we do is, in the application program, we will put one SQL statement to access the data from the database. Clear? So normally SQL injection operation perform on websites, but we can also perform the SQL injection attack on any databases. So SQL injection will allow the attacker to spoof identity, tampers with existing data, that means modification in existing data, then destroy the data or make the data public, or they can also become the administrator of the database server. So they can do whatever the performance they want to do. So SQL injection is a type of an injection attack that makes it possible to execute malicious SQL statement. So we can execute the malicious SQL statement through the SQL injection, and we can access the data that has been stored in database. So this statement control a database server behind a web application. So attacker can use SQL injection vulnerability to bypass application security measures. So if there is any weakness in application program, then the attacker will use that weakness to attack the database through the SQL injection statements, and it can identify the data from the database. So as you see in the figure, that is one application program, and that is another is a database. So we can run the SQL statement in between the application program and database, and we can access the data that has been stored in databases. So that is this is all about SQL injection. Now next is the malicious code. It is also called as a malware. So basically malicious code or malware refer to a software that has been designed for some malicious activities. So all the software that has been designed for the malicious activities will be called as a malicious codes. this type of software are designed to cause the damage to a system. So this type of software can delete your file, modify your file, or it can also damage your confidential information that has been stored in your computer system. So there are several categories of malicious codes. Some of the category you may aware of. So the first is virus. So virus is also called as a malicious code or malware. So it attaches itself to program and infect other programs and system files. We all aware of the working of the virus. Next is worm. This is also called as a malicious code. So we know that the worm can travel from one machine to another machine through the network. So infect one system and travel to another system through network. Next is logic bomb. So these are the software that trigger actions when condition occurs. So some condition will occur and this software will trigger its action and damage the system or information. Then Trojan horse. So programs with unexpected additional functionalities will be called as a Trojan horse. So let's suppose you install some third party software and it will install unexpected additional functionalities. That functionalities will steal your data from your systems. So that type of software will be called as a Trojan horse. Then exploits. So these are the specialized codes specific to software vulnerabilities. So for the software weakness, specific code will be generated that will be called as a exploit. So we can exploit the vulnerability of the software. Next is downloader. So it will install other items on targeted machines. So downloader will do, it will install the other items. So let's suppose you are downloading Office, Microsoft Office from any website. Clear. And it will also install other items with Microsoft Office that is malicious to the targeted system. Next is auto router. So this is the hacker tool to break into new systems. So hacker will use this tool to break into the new systems. Then virus kit. So these are the software kit to generate the new viruses automatically. So this kit will help the attacker to create new viruses and spread the viruses to the targeted system. Next is spammer program. So all we get the spam emails in our email accounts. So this program used to send large number of unwanted emails. The next is flooders. So normally we use the attacker use the flooders in to perform the DDoS attack. So it will attack the computer network with large volume of traffic for DDoS attack. So it will create a fake traffic in computer network. Then keylogger captures a keystroke on system. So when any keylogger is installed in your targeted system, then whatever the key will be pressed by the user from the keyboard, all the keys will be captured in the software. And from that captures, we can identify useful information like username and passwords. Then rootkit, setup tool to gain root level access in targeted system. So we can also gain the root level, all the administrator rights in targeted system by using the rootkits. Then zombie. So these are the programs activated on an infected machine that is activated to launch attack on another machine. So for the DDoS attack, we use the zombies. So we install the zombies in particular machines and that machine will attack another machine. So to perform the DDoS, distributed denial of service attack, we use the zombies. So this was the all about SQL injection and malicious code. So this is the end of our unit number one. Now let's have a quick recap of our unit number one, what we have discussed in unit number one. So in the first lecture, we have started with threat to security. So we have seen the definition of threat. So any potential act that causes the damage to a computer system will be called as a threat. So threat can be a logical also and threat can be a physical also. So we have various categories of threats, viruses, worms, intruders, insiders that we have seen in the first lectures. The next lecture we have seen the steps in attack. So to perform any attack, we have basically four steps. First is reconnaissance, second is scanning, third is researching vulnerability, and fourth is performing attack. So in the first step, in the reconnaissance, we gather as much as information possible for any organization. In the scanning, we do some scanning like port scanning and IP address scanning. So IP address scanning will help us to identify the information about the IP network and the live machines in particular organization. And the port scanning will help us to identify the application that has been running on particular machine in organization. So if we identify that the port number 443 is running on any system, then we can conclude that the web service application is running on that computer. So we can identify the useful information from scanning. Next is researching vulnerability. So by in this step we try to identify the weakness in the softwares. So first of all, after identifying the softwares that are running on the computer system by scanning, we try to identify the software weaknesses in that particular machines, and after that we perform the attack. So performing attack will be our last step in steps in attack. After that we have seen security basics. So we have seen confidentiality, integrity and availability, and we have seen the definition of computer security, and we have seen the definition of information security. So the definition of computer security is process to secure the confidentiality, integrity and availability will be called as a computer security. And information security, the process of protecting the confidentiality, integrity and availability of the information will be called as a information security. Now what is confidentiality? So the meaning of confidentiality is unauthorized user will not have access to a confidential information. So to any unauthorized user will not be allowed to access the confidential information. Integrity, the meaning of integrity is any unauthorized person cannot modify the information. So any confidential information will not be allowed to modify by the unauthorized user. And what is the meaning of availability? Whenever the authorized user requests to access that information must be available. That is the availability. So it is also called as a CIA threat. So this is the three basic pillars of computer or the information security: confidentiality, integrity and availability. And to protect the process to protect the confidentiality, integrity and availability of any computer system will be called as a computer security. After that we have seen types of attack. So in we have two categories of attack. First is active attack, second is passive attack. So in the active attack we do some modification in information, but in passive attack we do not do any modification or damage the computer or informations. So in the active attack we try to damage the computer system or informations, but in passive attack we are not damaging any computer system or information. So passive attack will be very hard to detect, and in active attack we try to identify the active attack and we try to recover from that active attack. So in the active attack we have four categories: masquerade, replay, modification of message and denial of service, that we have seen in detail in the previous lectures. And in the passive attack we have two categories of passive attack: release of message content and traffic analysis. After that we have seen various types of attacks that can be performed in IT environment. We have seen spoofing, we have seen sniffing, then we have already seen man in the middle attack. Then today we will see SQL injection and malicious code. So that was the activity, attacks that can be performed in computer system. So this is the end of our unit number 1. I hope you did understand all the topics that we have discussed in previous 6 lectures about unit number 1. After completing this lecture, you need to appear in quiz assignment via Google Classroom. Thank you so much.